Broadcaster Derryn Hinch has emerged from court beaming after fighting charges for naming sex offenders. The terminally ill anti-pedophile campaigner faces an anxious two-week wait for the magistrate's verdict.
Surrounded by supporters and with his wife by his side, Derryn Hinch and his lawyers are asking the same question as Shakespeare. What's in a name?
I'm feeling very good about today. I think we got a great hearing, and I think all the issues we wanted to raise have been raised, and that's all you can ask for.
On the waiting list for a liver transplant, the 67-year-old pleaded not guilty to identifying two sex offenders on his website and at a name and shame protest on the steps of Parliament.
Well, people said, why are you pleading not guilty? And I said, well, I'm not going to be guilty to a crime that the High Court maybe said I didn't commit.
His defence team argues by simply naming the offenders, they can't be identified because there could be others with the same name. But the prosecution says there was enough in the public domain prior to the rally for people to put two and two together.
Any time a journalist does his job, if anybody can go on Google and Google the world and find something, then we're all in breach.
The only time Hinch appeared a little anxious was when audio of the 2008 rally was played in court. But even then, the names of the offenders were beeped. After 3 hours of submissions, the magistrate won't rule until June 3, a fortnight away.
Life goes on. Life goes on. You do your job, you do what you do, you do what you think is right, and it goes on.
Melanie Davies, 10 News.